Hiatus by 730 Lectures is brought to you by OneInManila.com and the John Gokongwei School of Management Sanggunian.
Hi, I'm John Young. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Avian School, an edutech startup based here in Manila. And we teach Filipinos to become software engineers in 12 weeks for a share of their future income. So wherever or whenever you're watching this, this talk is about the hacker's mindset and how to work through problems. I've used the same framework to sneak in the biggest tech conference in Asia. And this is a story I have yet to share publicly, but I'm happy to share it on this platform. So after graduating high school, I knew I wanted to enter the tech industry. Now, normally you'd have to take IT in college, wait a couple of years, and only then start your career. That's way too long, and I wanted to know what it takes as early as possible, which introduces me to my first problem. You know, I didn't know anyone. I didn't know someone who could introduce me in. I did some research, and I realized that the biggest tech giants usually clump together in these tech conferences. But I didn't want to just watch these people. You know, if I did, I could have just gone online. No, I wanted to meet them, you know, figure out what brought them success and really prime their brains for advice. So scrolling through the internet, I found this conference called RISE, which brought executives from Stripe, Uber, Tinder, and all these really big names. It was perfect. It's at Hong Kong, so not too far from Manila. And it's in about 2 months' time. And I can meet all the right people I was looking for. But when I looked at the price, it cost about $1,500 per ticket and almost $6,000 just to meet the speakers involved. That's roughly 280,000 pesos per pass, and it's just such an insane price. I didn't have that kind of money to spare, and even if I did, I don't think I would have paid for it. I sat on it for a couple of days, and I came up with a plan. I shared the idea with some friends, and they were on board. Over the next few slides, I will share with you guys what went over the next couple of months, and how we hacked our way into the biggest tech conference in Asia.
So step one, right? Build traction. At the time, my friends and I were reading this book called Trust Me, I'm Lying by Ryan Holiday. He's the guy who predicted the rise of fake news, and in his book, exposed a lot of the loopholes, techniques he used to leverage media to his own advantage. And we thought, you know, we could do something like that. We could use the same techniques he shared and apply it in our own project. You know, it can't be that hard to write something engaging or controversial. So it started by building this fake blog called Dropout Learning. The joke there is that, you know, what does the tech industry love more than smart dropouts? So we spent the next week writing that first article, or at least tried to write it, then actually wrote it, and then we were ready. It was basically this piece shedding some light on the local educational system, you know, the culture Philippines promotes, how it's stagnant because we rely on school as our source of truth, and we forget to hustle and learn on our own. While the philosophy and the ideas behind it were very much authentic and true, there were some minor tweaks to assure virality. From the writing style, to the picture, to the channels that would be shared, to the time it would be posted, all of these were meticulously crafted to gain traction. And at that time, we were ready. So we hit posts, and the next thing you know, some blogs were sharing it. It was on Facebook, LinkedIn, Reddit, people I've never met pass it around. I've seen people argue about it, applaud it, and just this whole mix of polarizing opinions. And that's what we wanted, right? To stir up conversation. The more people talked about this, the more viewership our channel would receive. And once it started, it couldn't stop. It just carried on under its own power. So if you're listening to this right now and you saw that article, it's probably not even out of chance. Like, we made sure that happened. So here are a couple of stats. So in a night, we reached about 10,000 people. In a week, around 30,000. And of course, you know, other articles on larger channels do way more. But for a couple of 18-year-old kids, with no experience in writing or marketing, you know, that was surprising. If you could gather a team with the same vision, work, you know, something would pop out at the other end. We also wrote a couple more articles later on to populate the blog and look legit, which brings me to my next pillar, you know, selling yourself. Okay, so now that we had traction, we could engage in the bigger ideas. So I emailed RISE, told them we had a following in Manila, reached thousands of people every night. You know, they didn't know that it was only for that week. I told them we write about tech, you know, startups, education, and I have my media and tech team ready, and we'd love to cover your event. And they're like, wow, tech team. Little did they know that our only media equipment was just like two smartphones. And we had a call, and they kept asking how old we were, what we've done. I said, you know, don't worry, we're professionals. We've done this multiple times. And a couple weeks went by, and they sent the tickets. So imagine at that point, we'd have saved around $12,000 or at around 600,000 pesos. So insane. So we got everything ready. We booked our flights, a place to stay, and even printed out calling cards to keep up with your story. So if you check the website, this is what you'd find. That's me beside the Uber CTO, and that's my buddy Javi beside one of the Klook founders. But you know, we don't just want to be beside these guys on screen, right? we want to meet them in person. Which brings me to my next point, maximizing opportunity. So this is a part where it gets more crazy. Now that we were media, we had access to all the speakers, and I mean all of them. And that's where making the most out of your situation really comes in. So there was this messaging app that gave access to all the media and speakers, and Javi and I were just sending messages constantly. So we were booked with interviews for the week, you know, speakers of the event, people visiting from the Valley, the tech leads of Hong Kong, and at one point we'd even be trending because we were so active online. You know, the point I really want to drill down here is that I see a lot of people with great opportunities but aren't milking it to its full potential. That's what we try to do at least, and so we set calls with people. This is one of the speakers of the event. He heads FinTech Association at Hong Kong, and so we sat him down for a quick 13-minute chat. So very valuable insights. Another one is the CNBC tech host. So right after he's done reporting, even if we didn't set anything formal, Javi and I would walk up to him, you know, chat him for a bit, told us about his life, you know, going around the world, interviewing the biggest tech stars of Silicon Valley. And for kicks, Javi and I would even take turns, you know, passing around in the news background. You know, I can go on and on about the amazing people we met, like the founder of Giphy, the guy behind all the gifts that you send on Messenger or comment on Facebook, or the people who run FinTech here in C. But the biggest highlight of my trip was meeting this guy called Will Gabrick. So if you don't know, Will is the CFO and Chief Product Officer of Stripe, the $35 billion company in payments, and one of the highest valued startups right now in the States. He's really one of the people I have huge amount of respect for. So I was sneaking around backstage while Will was rehearsing for his talk. I walk up to him, I told him my story, and that I hacked my way to meet people like him. He gave a good laugh, and he took some time off to chat with me. As much as he was providing me with invaluable advice on, you know, spending a huge amount of time with my users or thinking about products long term, there was one piece of advice I'll never forget. So Will told me that I should stop sneaking around conferences and start building things. You know, since then, 100% of my focus has been exactly that. And he just put me in the direction I'm in right now. If you're going to get anything out of the story, let's go back to the idea of hacking. You know, people think that you need to know computers to hack systems, but that isn't true. To be a hacker requires two things: the willingness to question dogma and the courage to break a few rules. Not in a rebellious sense, but going against how most people think. Because by looking at problems without any preconceptions, you can look at situations for what they are, as opposed to what people think they are. You know, once you get to that point and hone that intuition, you will find the best solutions appear. And people will tell you that there's a defined set of rules to go about life, but you can't fall for that. You know, to paraphrase Steve Jobs, he says, "When you grow up, you tend to get told that the world is the way it is, and your role is to live within those boundaries. You know, try not to bash into the walls too much, go to school, get a job, start a family, but that's a very limited life. Life can be so much broader once you discover one simple fact. Everything around you called life was made up by people no smarter than you. And you can change it, you can influence it, you can mold it. And once you learn that, you'll never be the same again." What Steve means is that you should live life with no fear. So go out, break a few rules, and push your ideas forward. I hope you guys learned something today, and feel free to reach out to me online. If you want to know what I'm working on, do watch that interview I had with Zach that's posted on their Facebook page. And I'm basically building this remote school that teaches Filipinos to become software engineers. My co-founder, Victor Yuser, on growth and customer success in PayMongo. I work product at the top startups here. We're backed by the co-founder of Tinder and the same investors of companies like SpaceX, Brex, and Lyft. So shoot me an email if you're interested, or visit our website at avionschool.com. Thanks, everyone.